Good morning children. Division algorithm for polynomials. If p of x and g of x are two polynomials with g of x not equal to 0, then we can find a two polynomials q of x and r of x such that p of x equal to g of x into q of x plus r of x, where r of x equal to 0 or degree of r of x less than degree of g of x. This result is known as division algorithm for the polynomials. So it is nothing else our division algorithm for the normal division only. When the normal division is there, we know one rule, that is dividend equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. Sometimes our remainder is 0, and we know that when we are doing the normal division, suppose I am taking as a 72 with the division with 9. We will get a remainder 0. Suppose I am taking 73. Again, suppose I am taking as a 80. So when we have seen a 72 divided with a 9, we are getting a remainder 0. 73, then the remainder became 1, and 80, then remainder became 8. Now if you do the multiplication with the 81, then what is that one? 9 9 is 81, the remainder is 0. So it will never equal to, our remainder is never equal to divisor. This is the normal procedure. This is the normal procedure of a division. Here also the same thing, only p of x is our dividend. When we are dividing with a g of x, which is a divisor, you are going to get a result that is quotient. So quotient we are using q of x and the remainder r of x. This shows that each are in the polynomial x. P of x polynomial in x, g of x also in the variable x, quotient also x only, remainder also x they are showing. Then what is the next part? Sometimes r of x equal to 0, that is in this case we can see in our remainder is 0, though 0, same case here also. Either r of x equal to 0 or degree of r of x less than the degree of the divisor. They are connected. Degree of the r of x is less than degree of g of x. We know that when the remainder we are getting in a normal division, the remainder is always less than divisor only. Otherwise, it is equal to 0. The never remainder is equal to divisor, right? So, here we know that the remainder is less than the divisor. The same rule we have to do with the degree of the polynomials. Degree of the r of x is less than degree of the divisor. Now let us go through the definition once again. What is the definition? P of x and g of x are any two polynomials with the g of x not equal to 0. That means the divisor is not equal to 0 only possible. Next, what is the result? P of x equal to g of x into q of x plus r of x. Now what is the meaning of that one? Dividend equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. G of x is the divisor, q of x is the quotient, r of x is the remainder. Now what is the next part? Where r of x equal to 0, in the normal division I explained why this point came, and degree of the r of x is less than degree of the g of x also. So always the remainder is less than the divisor in the normal rule. Here in terms of the degree we have to speak, since it is a polynomial. This result is known as the division algorithm for the polynomials. So once again, p of x equal to g of x into q of x plus r of x, where r of x equal to 0 and degree of r of x is less than degree of g of x. Divide p of x equal to 3x square minus x cube minus 3x plus 1 by g of x, x minus 1 minus x square, and verify the division algorithm. When we are doing a division algorithm or division of a polynomial, we must write the polynomial in their standard form. So standard form to be written, what we have to write up, we have to write the polynomial in the standard form. But here it is not in standard form. First is x square, then x cube is there. So which is the highest degree, that should come in the first. So let us take down what is p of x equal to minus x cube plus 3x square minus minus 3x plus 5. Now what is the divisor? Divisor is g of x. So we'll write here g of x equal to, that is also not in the standard form. So minus x square will come first, then plus x, then minus 1. Now we have to write the division method, long division method only we have to use here. So I'll write the polynomial first. Minus x cube plus 3x square minus 3x plus 5. Now the divisor part, minus x square plus x minus 1. So we have already seen the division method. Let us see once again. What is the first term of the dividend? Minus x cube to be divided with the first term of the divisor, that is equal to minus x square, which is equal to x only. So I'll write here x, then x should be multiplied with each term. X into minus x square is minus x cube, then x into x plus x square, then minus x. Opposite sign, it will get cancelled. Again minus, minus became plus. 3x square minus x square, it is equal to 2x square. Then 3x minus 3x plus x only, so minus 2x. The next term plus 5. Now 2x square divided by minus x square. What I had done here, the first term of the next dividend, that is 2x square, to be divided with the first term of the divisor. So x square will get cancelled. So minus 2 only. So I'll write here minus 2. So multiply each term now. Minus 2 into minus x square. So 2x square only. Then minus 2x, because minus 2 into x, minus 2 and minus 1, it is plus 2 only. So change of sign, it will get cancelled. Again change of sign, it will get cancelled. Here minus 2 became 3 is the remainder. So we have to divide, they told, and the division algorithm, they told. So we have already written p of x and g of x. So what is the next step for us? Quotient q of x equal to quotient x minus 2, r of x equal to remainder equal to 3, remainder equal to 3. Now we got all the values, p of x we got, g of x we got, q and r of x also we have got. Verify division algorithm. So when we are doing the division algorithm, what we should write? The right hand side we should write. What is the right hand side? There, g of x into q of x plus r of x. Right? What is g of x? X minus 2. What is the q? Sorry, what is the, g of x equal to minus x square plus x minus 1. What is q of x? It is x minus 2. Then the remainder is plus 3. So just multiply with these terms. Minus x square into x minus x cube. Next, minus x square into minus 2 plus 2x square. Plus x into plus x into x only, the both are plus. So x square, x into minus 2 minus 2x, minus 1 into x minus 1, then plus 2 plus 3. So minus x cube we got, 2x square plus x square, that is 3x square, minus 2x. See, listen here, x is not written, so minus 1 into x only, so minus x is there. Now minus 2x minus x, what is the answer? Minus 3x. Then 2 plus 3, that is the answer, plus 5, which is our dividend. It is equal to p of x. Therefore, p of x equal to g of x into q of x plus r of x. Verified. Now one more point I just want to tell you that here we got a remainder is 3 only. If the remainder is 3 means it's a constant polynomial. What is the degree of the constant polynomial? 0. So what is the degree of the divisor here? 2, right? So the degree of the divisor is less than the degree of the polynomial divisor, right? So that also we can cross check. If you are getting higher degree than your divisor, then our step is wrong only. Now we have done verification. Now we can do the next question. Find all zeros of p of x equal to 2x raised to 4 minus 3x cube minus 3x square plus 6x minus 2. If two of its zeros are root 2 and a minus root 2. So let us write what is p of x. Similar sum we have done last year, but not with the root sign and all, normal roots are we have taken. So 2x raised to 4 minus 3x raised to 3 minus 3x square plus 6x minus 2. Now I am doing the first part. What is the zeros? X equal to root 2 and x equal to minus root 2 are the zeros. Okay. Are zeros of p of x. That means x minus root 2 and x plus root 2 are the factors. Or what we can say, x square minus root 2 square. That means x square minus 2 only. X square minus 2 is the factor of p of x. This is the first part. Now we identify the factor. We should do the long division method. So that means p of x to be divided with the x square minus 2. That is the second step. So p of x will write here 2x raised to 4 minus 3x cube minus 3x square plus 6x minus 2 to be divided with x square minus 2. Now what is the next step? 2x raised to 4 to be divided with x square. So this will be x square only. So 2x square we are getting. So 2x square I'll write. Then multiply with each term. So 2x square into x square, 2x raised to 4. But here one problem is the 2 into 2, 4x square with minus sign. So I should not write below x cube. We should write below x square only. Now we are having this one. So here nothing is there. I told that always we should add the coefficient with a 0 only. Otherwise some children will do the error. We'll continue now. What is the next step? Subtraction. So change of sign. Here also minus. Minus became plus. So minus 3x cube. There is no change because the other coefficient is 0 only. Now minus 3 and a plus 4. So what is the answer? Plus x square. Next term are 6x only. Again minus 3x cube by x square only. So it is equal to minus 3x. So I am writing here minus 3x and multiplying with each term. So what we will get? Minus 3x cube then plus 6x only. So again here nothing is there. So 0x square I am writing here. So it will get cancelled. Right? So x square minus 0 means x square only. And what is the last term? Minus 2. Here also 0x. Okay. Now x square by x square, what is the answer? 1 only. Again multiply x square minus 2. So what is the answer? Change of sign, it will get cancelled. Here 0. Otherwise also, we know that x square minus 2 is a factor. So definitely our remainder should be 0 only. So now we got the remainder is 0. Now what is the next step? Third part. P of x equal to x square minus 2 into the quotient 2x square minus 3x plus 1. The remainder is 0 only. So which rule? Division algorithm we have applied here. So p of x equal to g of x into q of x plus remainder x, that is equal to 0 only. Now what is the next step? I should go for the factors of this one. That is already we know the question. It is x plus root 2 and x minus root 2. Now what about this part? That we should go for the splitting middle term. So 2 into 1, 2 only. So the factors are 2 and 1 only. But we need minus 3 as a sum. So both will be minus. So here again 2x square minus 2x minus x plus 1. We had done splitting the middle term. This factors should continue till the end. So x minus root 2 and x plus root 2 are the first two factors. Now what is common here? 2x common. So x minus 1. Again minus 1 common, x minus 1. So x plus root 2, x minus root 2, x minus 1 is the next common, then 2x minus 1. Here just ask the factors only, and we have used 3 steps procedure for this one. First we identify the factor. Using the factor we have done the long division method. Next what is the step? We done the quotient splitting middle term method. We factorized and from there we got 2 more factors. Now the question is asked for what are the zeros. Therefore the zeros are root 2, change a sign, minus root 2, 1, then 1 by 2. So 4 root 2 we got, 4 roots we got here. Obtain all the zeros of 3x raised to 4 plus 6x cube minus 2x square minus 10x minus 5 if 2 of its zeros are root 5 by 3 and minus root 5 by 3. So always for the solution we should mention what is p of x. So p of x equal to 3x raised to 4 plus 6x cube minus 2x square minus 10x minus 5. Now root 5 by 3 and minus root 5 by 3 are zeros of p of x. Therefore, x minus root 5 by 3, x plus root 5 by 3 equal to x square minus 5 by 3 is the factor of p of x. So since it is coming as a fraction, we can use 1 by 3 common also. So 1 by 3 into 5x square, 1 by 3 into 3x square minus 5 we can take. So our divisor becomes 3x square minus 5 only, right? Then also its answer is correct only. So what is the factor we have to go for division? Or a divisor, what we should take? We can take 3x square minus 5. Anybody wants to continue like this, they can also, because 5 by 3 fraction comes. So there may be some possibility of doing errors there. Now we have written dividend as well as the divisor. Now 3x raised to 4 divided by 3x square only. So just we will get x square here. So x square into 3x square, 3x raised to 4. Then for x square into minus 5, minus 5x square. So there is, we are not getting any term with a x cube only. So 0x cube I am writing. After the change of sign, it will get cancelled. Here change of sign, what is the next term? It is 6x cube we have to take down. And minus 2x square plus 5x square. This means 3x square. And the next term is 10x. So what is the next point to be taken? 6x cube divided by 3x square only. So here 2 and here 1x. So it is 2x only. So I'll write here 2x. Again multiplication. That is 6x cube minus 10x only. So here we'll write a 0x square. Next term I should take down, that is 5 only. Minus 5. 3x square by 3x square, it is 1 only. So I'll write here 1, and again after the multiplication, what we'll get? Everything will get cancelled because it changes sign. So remainder, that means the divisor is a factor only. We should get the remainder is 0. So now what is the next third part? P of x equal to x square minus 5 by 3. X square minus 5 by 3. I can write or x square plus 2x plus 1 is the quotient. So I can write here 1 by 3 into 3x square minus 5 we can write. And x square plus 2x plus 1 can be written as x minus x plus 1 whole square only. Now this part what we can write because it's a given part only. So there only we have written x minus root 5 by 3 and x plus root 5 by 3 are the zeros of the factors we got. X plus 1 whole square means x plus 1 is repeated 2 times only. So 4 factors we got. Therefore zeros are root 5 by 3 minus root 5 by 3, then minus 1 and minus 1. With this, today's video I'm winding up.